Hey Premiere Pros, it's Paul Murphy here, and today I wanted to show you an easier way to fill a frame with a blurred background. Okay, so I have a sequence here that has a whole heap of vertical footage that's in a horizontal timeline. And what I want to do is fill that empty space with a blurred, scaled up version of the image. Now, the way that I've usually seen people solve this problem in the past is by duplicating the clips. And that's fine if you're doing it in a rush, but the problem there is if you then start making changes to your edit, you always have to make those changes to everything twice. So I wanted to come up with a way that was very quick to do this that could be applied to any clips on the timeline. So what I'm going to do in this case is I'm going to start with a graphic. So I'm going to make sure I've got my timeline selected. I'm going to go over to my properties panel and I want to choose create new graphic, and I'm going to choose a rectangle, and then I'm just going to go to this rectangle here in my program monitor and just stretch this out so that it covers all of my frame. Now, the interesting thing about any layer inside of Premiere Pro is that it can actually be turned into an adjustment layer. And an adjustment layer is a layer that's on a track that you add effects to, and it will affect everything below that track. So what I'm going to do is go to my graphic in the timeline and right click and choose adjustment layer. And now nothing has happened because I haven't added any effects to this yet. To do that, I'm going to go over to my effects panel. And what I want to do is first grab my transform effect, and I'll click and drag this above the shape in my properties panel. I'll get my Gaussian blur, because that's a very fast rendering blur, and I'll add that above the transform effect. And then finally, I'll get the brightness and contrast effect and drag that above the blur. So now I've got three effects that I want to adjust the image below here. So I'm going to go over to my effect controls, and the first thing I'll do is I'll find my transform effect, and I'm going to scale this up until it fills the frame. Then I'll go over to my Gaussian blur effect and I'll turn this up until it's nice and blurred out. And then finally, I'll go over to my brightness and contrast, and I'll just turn the brightness down. So that's pretty much the effect that we want for everything outside of the actual image itself. Of course, it's being applied to everything at the moment. But what we can do, because this is a graphic, we can actually add a mask to this. So to do that, I'm going to go over to my properties panel, and over here in my new item button, I actually want to add a new rectangle, and that's added it to the top of the stack here. I'm going to name this mask just so I can tell what it is. And then I'm going to go down the bottom here and I'm going to say mask with shape, and then I want to click invert that mask. So now the effect is being applied to everything that's outside of that shape that I just created. So now all I need to do is adjust the edges of this rectangle so that they go to the edges of the vertical frame. And now the effect is being applied to everything outside of that rectangle, and everything inside of it is being left as it is. And because this is an adjustment layer, it means I can just extend it across my entire clip and it will be applied to every bit of footage on my timeline. And there you go. Now you have an adjustment layer that you can use anywhere in your project whenever you want to fill the frame with a blurred out background. I hope you found this video useful, and if you did, please like and subscribe, and hey, maybe check out some of these other videos.